new students, they are going to be initiated today. But one thing we should note, that people may not think that we are concerned with something old-fashioned. When the world is progressing to reach the moon planet, we are chanting Hare Krishna. The people may not misunderstand that we are lagging behind with the scientific advancement. We have already passed all these scientific advancements. In the Bhagavad Gita, this attempt of the human being to reach other higher planets is not a new thing. They are advertising in the paper that the man's first step in the moon planet. But they do not know millions and millions of men went there and they have again come back. This is not the first time. This is time-old practice. And in the Bhagavad Gita, it is clearly stated, Abrahma bhavana lokan punaravartina. My dear Arjuna, even if you go to the highest planetary system, which is called Brahma loka, punaravartina, you have to come back. So this is not a new thing. This is known to these Krishna conscious people. So, Krishna says, we should always remember that we are Krishna conscious people. What Krishna says, we take it as the absolute truth. Therefore, Krishna says that even if you attain to reach the highest planet, which is called Brahma Loka, there are many planetary systems according to Vedic literature. The planetary system in which we are now, this is called Bhuloka. Above this planet system is Bhuvar Loka. Above that planetary system, there is Saraloka. This moon belongs to the Saraloka planetary system. Above the Saraloka, there is Janaloka. Then above that, there is Mahaloka. Above that, there is Sataloka. Similarly, there are below planetary systems. Tal, atal, nital, talatal, patal, rasatal, like that. So there are 14 status of planetary system within this universe. And our Gayatri mantra, Om Bhur Bhuvasa Tas Savitu Varannam Bhargav Dhivasa Dhimahi. The sun is the chief planet within this universe. So the sun is described in the Brahma Sanghita. Jachakshuri sasavita sakala grahanam raja samasta suramurtirase satija jasadaya bhramati saṁ bhitakāla-cakro Govindamadipurisham tamaham bhajami. So our aim is Govindamadipurisham. It is not that those who are worshipping Govinda, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, they are not aware of this. They know it very well. And therefore, in this verse, it is said, Jachakshure sa savita sakala grahanam. The sun is the chief amongst all planetary systems. It is just like the eye. Or it is the eye of the Supreme Law. Jachakshure sa savita sakala savita sakala grahanam. Actually, without sun, we cannot see. We may be very proud of our eyes. Can you show me what you can see? First of all, let me know. You cannot see even your next door neighbor by your eyes. You are challenging, can you show me God? What you can see? What is the value of this nonsense eyes? But things are going on. Some great Swami, rishis, this spiritual master, not at that time Swami, he was a student. Oh, can you show me God? He said, yes. And he said, yes, I have seen God. Oh, God is so cheap thing. You cannot see anything. What to speak of God? Without sunshine, therefore the sun is called Jachakshuresa sakala grahana. Without sunrise you are blind. You are blind. At night, can you see anything? You have to arrange for electricity, these, that, so many things, because the sun is not there. Try to understand everything practically. Don't be fools. So, this sun is only one sun, but there are millions and trillions of suns. That is also stated in the Brahma Sangita. Jasya prabha prabhavato jagadanda koti koti sasesa vasudhadi vibhuti bhinnam. Tad brahma nishkalam anantam asesa bhutam govindam adipurusham tamaham bhajami. Jasya prabha prabhavato. The bodily effulgence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, Govinda, is called Brahma Jyoti. In that Brahma Jyoti, there are millions and trillions of universes. Just like within the sun sign, there are millions and trillions of planets. Similarly, in the effulgence, shining effulgence of the body of Krishna, which is called Brahma Jyoti, Jasya Prabha, Prabhavato, Jagadanda Koti. So we get information, millions and trillions of universes. And in each universe there is one sun. So there are millions and trillions of universes and trillions of suns and moons and planets and so many things. What Krishna says, that if you try to go in one of these planets, then you'll simply waste your time. That's all. Simply waste your time. Practically also, you see, now somebody has gone to the moon planet. But what will you get? and what the human society will get out of it. After spending so much money, so much energy, 10 years adventure, if you have gone to moon planet and simply touched it, then what is the benefit out of it? You remain there and call your other friends, come here. And even if you go there and remain there, what benefit will go? Abrahma bhuvana lokan punaravartina arjuna. So long we are in this material world, either this planet or other planet, the four things, birth, death, old age and disease will follow you. You cannot get rid. Suppose if you go and domicile in moon planet, if you can, of course, by oxygen mask, how long you can stay. But if you get that opportunity to stay there, then what you will gain? You will gain a little more duration of life. That's all. Not that you are going to live forever there. No, that is not possible. So, a little duration of life increase. What do you gain by that? Are the trees are not living for many, many years? Tarava kinna jivanti. In your country I have seen, and San Francisco, there is a wood, there is a tree, 7,000 years old. But what is the benefit? If you stand up in a place for 7,000 years, and if you are proud of your living 7,000 years, is that a very great credit? Standing up. So Krishna says, all these things are nonsense. Abrahma bhuvana lokan punaravartinati. You will have to come back again. It is a great story how one goes to the moon planet, how he again comes back. These are all stated in the Vedic literature. It is not a very new thing. But what is our aim? Our aim is different. We are not going to waste our valuable time. Krishna says, so don't waste your time by these attempts that you will go to this planet, to that planet, to that planet, to that planet. What you will get? Your material miseries will follow you wherever you go. Therefore, in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is very nicely said by the author, keho pape keho punne kare visaya bhog bhakti gandha hini jate jaye bhavo rog. The purpose of this verse is, in this material world, somebody is enjoying, not enjoying, everybody is suffering. But something we take, it is enjoyment, and something we take, suffering. Actually it is suffering. Who is there within this material world who does not suffer in disease? Who is there within this material world who does not suffer from old age? Who is there within this material world who does not die? And who wants to die? Nobody wants to die. Nobody wants to die and everybody dies, then where is this enjoyment? Nobody wants to grow old and everybody becomes old, then where is enjoyment? Nobody wants to suffer from disease, and everyone suffers from disease. Then where is enjoyment? So this is all nonsense. Within this material world, there is no enjoyment. It is simply our concoction. This is enjoyment, this is suffering. Everything is suffering. Therefore, the Chaitanya Charitamrita says, the Vishaya Bhog. Vishaya means, what is that Vishaya? Vishaya means the four things. Eating, sleeping, mating, and defending. So, keho pape, keho punne. Pape means these four things will be there. But they may be third grade. Just like taking for accepted. You American, you have got this country, you have got this body, American body, by pious activity, because you are materially prosperous. And say in India, they are poverty stricken. Because I say, wherever I go, they speak of India is poverty stricken. Actually, it is at the present moment so. So it may be that they are suffering. But these four things, eating, you may be eating very nice things, butter, bread and so many things, and they might be eating without butter. But eating is there. It is not that because one is poverty stricken, the wholesale man has died for want of food. No. Not even birds and beasts. Not like this. So, this Vishaya Bhog, the, I want to say, participating, the four principles of bodily demands, namely eating, sleeping, mating and defending, that can be had in any circumstances. Even if you are born in impious condition or you are born in pious condition. But the problem is how to get out of these four principles of life, namely birth, death, old age and disease. That is the real problem. This is not real problem. What shall I eat? The birds and beasts, they have no problem. In the morning, they immediately chirping, kichir, 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 they have no problem. They know that we shall have our food. The cats and dogs also know, they are confident they will get some food. So nobody is dying. That's a mistake. That overpopulation, this and that, everyone has got, by God's arrangement, everyone has got food. But the quality may be different, that's all. But that quality of material enjoyment is not the end of life. The real problem is how to get out of these problems of life, birth, death, old age and disease. That cannot be solved by simply wasting time within these universe, this way or that way. Even if you go to the highest planet, these problems cannot be solved. Because there is also death. Although in the Brahma Loka, the duration in the moon planet, so far we have got information, they live for 10,000 of years. And there, one day is equal to our 6 months. So just imagine, that means 10,000 multiplied by 150, that is the duration of life in the moon planet. I do not know whether people from here will go to moon planet and live for so many days. That is not possible. Then the whole Vedic literature will be false. You can attempt to go there, make a first. But it is not possible to live there. That is not possible. So this knowledge we have got ready from the Vedic scriptures. Therefore, we are not very much concerned to go to this planet or that planet. We are concerned to go directly to the planet where Krishna is. That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. What is that? Janti devabrata devan pitrin janti pitribrataha bhuteja janti bhutani madjajin api janti maam. You can go to moon planet or sun planet. You can go even to sun planet. There are many millions and trillions of planets that you can go. Janti deva vrata divam. Similarly, there are pitri lokas planets. There also you can go. And if you want, you can remain. Bhuteja, if you become material, too much materialistic, you can remain here. But madhyajina, those who are devotees of mine, they come to me. So we are aiming to that point. Jadgatyana nivartante tadhyama paramama. So this initiation is not a first. This initiation means to initiate a person so that ultimately he can go to that supreme planet, Krishna Loka, Vrindavan. We are not sitting idly. We are also attempting to go to other planets. But that is not simply wasting time. This attempt will not be fruitful. Just attempt to go to Krishna. Fortunately, as coincidence, we have published one article in our Back to Godhead. Where is that? Yes. Here is an article in read. The name is, what is the name? Yes. Here is an article, Beyond the Universe. This article you will find. It is just fortunate that during this moment this article is also published. Beyond this universe. There is place beyond this universe. That universe information you will get from the Bhagavad Gita. Unfortunately, Bhagavad Gita is very popular book since a very long time. And there are so many publications of Bhagavad Gita in your country. And imported also from India, and you have also published. But all this nonsense, they do not know what is beyond this universe. All these rascals, they never preached, and they come here to preach Bhagavad Gita. I say rascals, because they did not give the real information. Simply bluff. Therefore, we have published this Bhagavad Gita as it is. Try to read it. You'll find that information. Parastasmat bhava anya bhaktya bhaktya sanatana. There is another nature. Just like you see this nature, nature you understand. This cosmic manifestation is called nature. Svabhava. But there is another nature. Para, that is superior. Bhava, anya, svabhava, another nature, anya, but that is different. How it is even bhaktya bhaktya sanatana, this manifested cosmic manifestation. This is one status, and beyond this there is covering of the universe that is not manifested. So, beyond this manifested and non-manifested existence of this universe, there is another nature. And what is that nature?
Sanatana. It all. And this nature, what is this nature? Bhaktya Bhaktya Pranashati. Bhutya Bhutya Pranashati. Vinashati. This material nature, you can understand, this is common sense. Anything manifested here, it will finish. Take for your example this body. Suppose you are 30 years old. 30 years before your body was not manifested. And say for another 50 or 50 years, it will be again non-manifested. That is a fact. Bhutya bhutya praliyate. It is manifested and again it annihilates, dissolves. Sagara lahari sama. Just like the waves in the sea, they're coming, very big waves, and immediately, within a second, finish. See, they do not study. They're simply concerned with this bubble life, which will be finished at any moment. As it is your body, it is manifested and it will be finished at any day. Similarly, the whole universe, this is also a gigantic material body and it will be finished. And when it will be finished, where is your moon planet, at this planet, at that planet? All finished. Why should you waste your time to go to such planets where everything will be finished? Try to go to Krishna Loka. Jadgatyana nivartanti tadhyama paramamma. This is science. Try to understand. You understand yourself and preach this message throughout the whole world. They are in the darkness. They have no knowledge, although they are very much proud. This is not advancement of knowledge. That you go after 10 years in the back to go to the moon planet and touch it and come back and become very proud. Oh, I have touched. And what is that? You have touched what you have gained. But they are proud simply by touching. That's all. Leave there. And if you leave, how long will you live? It will be all finished. Try to find out that planet. Jadgatana nivartanti sadhyam. Where going, nor coming back. You get eternal life and dance with Krishna. This is the initiation. Don't take this initiation and trifle. This initiation is giving you a chance to reach to Krishna and live there eternally and dance with Krishna. Thank you. What is that? Atman. This is my drinking water, but another water.
Should I light the candle?
Yes. So try to follow the rules and regulations, be strict to them. Your taktadeham punarjanmanaiti mameti. After this body, with this body, wherever you go, you'll simply touch and come back. That's all. Oh, you cannot leave. And even if you leave, how long will you leave? What is 10,000 years in comparison to the time eternal? First thing, you cannot leave, or neither you can go. And even if you leave, if you can go, it is not that you are going to get eternal. But our concern is how to get eternal life and dance with Krishna. That's all.
Where is that water? Why you forget? Just see how I'm going. 1, 2, 3, 4. Bulayenge. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Now chant. Nama Apa Vitra Pavitra Ba Sarva Vasyam Datu Api Ba Ja Smare Undari Kakhyam Sa Vaiham Abhantaram Suchi Sri Vishnu
Sri Vishnu
Sri Vishnu
Sri Vishnu
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Ram Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram Ram. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram Ram Ram. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Ram. Syllabus. Hare Krishna, Hare
Krishna.
You can divide into two and put the two pillars of the throne of Krishna. Don't put it on the floor.